Hi, everyone. Anthony Fantano here, Internet's busiest music nerd. You know who it is. I'm here to read some of your comments on reviews that have dropped over the past week or so. Let's get to it, shall we? Yes, it's true, but here's the challenge. Which one is from heaven and which one's from hell? Yeah, 2021's real freaking weird. Nice comment. Very submissive and breedable. Man, that dude's got to be just like crap in his pants right now. I mean, you do make a point. Does TPAB give you nightmares? Kids see ghosts? I wouldn't say my passion's gone or anything, but you know, I will admit personally, like the pandemic year has been hell. Technically true. This is a top three Lorde album, but for how long? I do doubt Lorde is going to end up seeing my review, but I wonder if she is as offline as she presents to be on the record, because that just may be a part of the narrative that she's kind of pushing on the LP. But I suppose if she was actually living that life, it would explain why this record seems like so disconnected and is having a hard time resonating with some people. For the most part, I agree over here, but I hope this ends up being a project that after we get a few better Lorde albums, we look back on it and we're like, hey, remember that crazy one that she did? That one, remember that one? There were some crazy ideas on that one. I see what you did there. I agree with what you're saying about the vocals on this one as well. I did have my reservations with them, but I didn't go too much into it in the review because I think there were bigger, you know, fish to fry as far as like problems that I had with it. But this higher register, this more nasally timbre, and some of the effects didn't exactly lead to a set of vocals on some of the tracks that compelled me as much as her earlier work. I agree with what you're saying over here, although part of me didn't want to necessarily frame it as that because I was wondering how much of that was like the satire or just, you know, the narrative she was concocting. But there is an element of it that does feel authentic and does feel real. And yeah, you know, that mindset is kind of like, this is like exactly what I was saying, because I mean, I do get the sense that to a degree, Lorde is taking that kind of person, taking that kind of mentality to task. But like, simultaneously, the record is so light in its criticisms of those people, if there are really any, that it could easily land with exactly that demo. A wild John Sudano. I mean, I'm glad that you enjoy the record more than me, but I'm also happier that you watched and commented. Sir, what are you doing? What are you doing? No, I don't have anything generally against this genre. Like, please just engage with my specific criticisms of the record. Well, it's not exactly in the middle of a renaissance now, is it? Well, my comment here was nothing against any of these bands or black gaze in general. Obviously, I enjoyed the new Panopticon record. When I say, you know, the trend of the genre has sort of like, you know, depleted, I'm merely talking about the trendiness of it. That's never to say that there aren't still artists out there still making the genre. I mean, as I said in my review, a lot of the people out there who, you know, helped popularize it in the first place are still pretty much sticking with it. And I think that's fine and that's respectable. It's not because when I use that term, you know exactly what I'm referring to. I agree. I think this new LP should be considered for a Grammy as well, and most likely it will be, but Grammys are mostly given either because a record is popular or just like symbolically as a celebration of, oh, hey, you've had this great career up until this point, so we're finally going to hand you a Grammy after all these years. And I feel like that was kind of the case with King's Disease, because Freddie did have the better record that year, but, you know, look, if King's Disease 2 got a Grammy too, I'd be happy with it. I appreciate appreciate you being hype about this record. I think this is one of his best projects in a while too, but part of what makes it so good is that he's not trying to just like redo all his 90s shit. He's not just trying to live in the past. I don't know, maybe give Eminem some time. We'll see. There were so many comments like this in the comment section. I don't know why you guys see Nas and for whatever reason you think Nav. Good comment, and I think that's what's sort of refreshing about this project. Nas isn't trying to, you know, force an old head sound or try to overly like appeal to that crowd. He is obviously dropping tracks that call back to his old stuff, but it's sounding new, it's sounding modern, it's sounding young, it's sounding refreshing. How did you know? Look, I'm not going to go over every single thing I notice in a review because I'm trying to give you an efficient breakdown and overview of whether or not it's appealing, and I hope that when you check it out, you notice those things. That's quite a statement. I mean, I don't know if I agree because I think 444 is really good, but certainly Jay-Z and Nas are both proving themselves to be capable at this stage in their careers. And there you have it, me reading your comments on the internet. We live in a society, I guess. Over here next to my head is another video that you can check out. Hit that up with a link to subscribe to the channel. Anthony Fantano reading comments forever.